categories, the short stubbies like I've been riding, or the longer, narrower, 7'6" range semi-guns. Surfboard, skateboard entrepreneur Jeff Ho, drawing some backside lines across some long, ruler edge waves at RINCON. It seems the shortboard had greatly enhanced the surfer's ability to ride backside. Even in a right point break wave like RINCON, that's mostly dominated by regular foots facing the wave. In the early 60s, George Greeno could still park by the side of the highway as Bob Cooper walked out around the corner to try to put his orange-colored blue machine into some green tunnels at RINCON. I was out in the water surfing when John Peck showed up, so I raced into the beach, set up my tripod and camera, and shot these few waves of John Peck, went back out in the water to catch a few more waves, and Corky Carroll showed up, riding his 10'6" Phil Edwards type Corky Carroll model, and I raced in, set up my tripod and camera to shoot these movies of Corky. Obviously, I had some conflicts about surfing and shooting surfing movies at the same time. When Miki Dora arrived, once again, I had to race to the beach, set up my tripod and camera to get this movie of him trying to decapitate the surfer who had taken off in front of him. He was a little bit too far behind to get him, so instead he intimidated the surfer behind him on the next wave. But what I find interesting is from this point out, you don't see any other surfers anywhere. On the wave, paddling out, in the lineup, plenty of seagulls, but just one surfer's head bobbing up for a second, right there. But other than that, it's just Miki Dora, all alone with this wave and his thoughts, all the way to the seawall at Inside RINCON in the winter of 1966. In the early 70s, RINCON was a little bit more of a log jam, with all the contemporary surfers of the day eager to get out in the water and try their new shorter surfboards and the challenging waves at RINCON. But there was also sort of a laid-back feel to it all, where if you're out in the water and had that perfect wave to yourself and suddenly you were confronted with Morang Carew from the Tijuana Slough, rather than taking his head off, you might just navigate some easy go-behinds on the glassy waves at RINCON, clear through to the inside lineup. But RINCON isn't always a fun performance wave. The storms of 1969 brought some huge swells wrapping around the point at RINCON. These movies shot by Hal Jebsen in 1969 during my hiatus from surf filmmaking, where if you took off on a wave that seemed to be head high, and then the swell wrapped around to the first point and hit one of the inside reefs, it would build up to being bigger than head high. It seems like a fairly easy wave to ride. It's just if you have to pull out of the wave, it might not seem to be so easy after all. Wayne Anoya writing here. Once again, sort of a slow, easy, thick wave to ride, which would be okay if you could just pull out without encountering a double overhead wall of whitewater outside. And that would be okay if you could just ride all the way to the beach and step off on the sand. Unfortunately, there's a 15-foot high seawall with the waves breaking right into them. An experienced surfer like Wayne Anoya could probably find an easy way out of the situation where a novice like Morang Carew from the Tijuana Slough might hang in there too long and have his board destroyed against the seawall. My pursuit,